What's up YouTube, Hot Lead Retired here. All right guys, it's been a while since I made a video. Just YouTube and I not getting along on the gun policy, so it kind of slowed me down. But anyway, I want to talk about my motor mount for a kayak trolling motor mount that I made. I got it right here. Guys, the way I made mine, I went on YouTube and looked at a bunch of designs to get some ideas about how to do it. And basically, they're all about the same, but I changed it a little bit. I wanted to add my battery box onto my motor mount. And basically, all this is a 2x4. I got 4 bolts. These are quick detach bolts because the way that it's mounted into the rod holders on the Teton Pro, Lifetime Teton Pro 1116. The rod holders are angled in and back, which is like 2 angles. So it's hard to flush mount a board on those 2 angles. But the way I did it, I put all this, because of the way the rod holders are angled, is to have it, you gotta take one side off. Cause it will not go in there if 2 sides, cause they're angled in toward each other and they're angled back. And I'm gonna show you how to install it and everything. And as far as the battery box goes, all I did was I ran a bolt from inside the battery box into the 2x4, and I just used the leftover pipe, PVC pipe, that I made these mounts for. I just cut off enough to make bushings for the bolts to help support the weight of the battery box. Anyway, it's a one-piece deal. If counting the battery, the mount, the box, the trolling motor, I'm setting around 24 to 25 pounds of weight added to my kayak, because weight was an issue. But anyway, I'm gonna show you how to install this. The quick detach side, I made that on the opposite side of my motor, and this side here is permanently mounted, and that's the side the motor mounts on. All right, to install this, you just unscrew these plastic knobs that I bought. And remove one side. And there's my bolts. These are my spacers to bring the board out even on the mount. All right, just slide that right in there. Guys, I cut me a little piece of styrofoam off a pool noodle to put under the battery box to give it some cushion and to make it more stable, because it was like a 1/4 inch or so off my deck. And the reason I did it like this, I didn't want to drill any holes in my deck, and I didn't want a whole bunch of bungee cords tying it down and stuff like that. All right, now put this other side in. You just always put the top one in first, because it's the one with the spacers. It's easier to do, I find it easier to do when I put the top one in first. All right. What I do is I put the screw in here, the bolt. I just rotate it that way. And then I put all my spacer stuff, a washer, 2 nuts. I mean, you can probably use any many different things for spacers. You can make your own spacer. You could probably cut a little piece of 3/4 inch PVC pipe and make a spacer. All right, once you get the bolts on, or spacers and stuff on there, you just move your board out, put it through the hole. Put it through the hole, put your washer on the front, get your knob, up. I just do it hand tight for the bottom bolt. Through the hole. Put the knob on. Tighten her down. Okay guys, that's pretty much it. That's the way it sets on here. These power cords, I just put them on there to hang, so I can hang this up in my building and keep it off the floor. The reason for the eye hooks is because on the Teton, the seat bungee cords that hold the seat back, the eyelets are on the rod holder and the board covers it up and I can't get to it. So I just put the eyes here and I just cross connect them here like that. And that's the way it mounts. That's the way it looks so far. This battery box is just a cheap battery box. It's made to fit my battery. I'm using a lightweight 11.5-pound lithium battery, 50 amp hours. Okay, so basically all you need is some, this here is 1-inch PVC pipe. I think the bolts are 5-inch bolts, I think. And the reason I got 5-inch, because I had to put spacers on here to make the board come out straight up and down. Because if you don't do that, the board's gonna lean back, and when you mount your trolling motor, it's gonna lean back, and you have to compensate for that. So I got an extra, 4-inch would work if you had a flat mount, but since I had to put spacers in here, I just bought, I think 5-inch, or maybe 4.5, 5-inch, I'm not sure. And they're 5/16 bolt. But you can measure your own, see how it does. So let me show you the trolling motor mount with the trolling motor on it. Okay guys, I went with the Water Snake 24-pound thrust trolling motor because of the weight. It weighs 4.85 pounds. So with this whole setup, counting the battery, is 11.5. And the battery box and the mount, the whole thing's gonna be around 26 pounds, 27 pounds, something like that. So I'm keeping the weight down. And if you notice, I mounted the trolling motor on. I mounted with the trolling motor mount, it's backwards. And the reason it's backwards is because I wanted the trolling motor as close to the, toward the seat as I could get it for comfortable control. And another little feature on this trolling motor is, you pull down on this thing, this little knob right here, the handle pops out. So that's pretty neat. But if I'd switched the mount around, the trolling motor would be on this side of the board, which would be about 4 to 5 inches more toward the rear, and it would be hard to reach back. And the way this is gonna work out, I don't see any problems with it. All right, the way I would work this motor, if I was coming in the shore to take my boat out of the water, and I'm getting in the shallow water, I would simply just turn this knob here, raise my trolling motor up, and either come in like that, because it's a lightweight motor. It's above the bottom of the kayak, so it's not gonna rub on the bottom or hit any rocks that your kayak wouldn't hit. But you could also, after you raise it, push this button here and just rotate it back, something like that, just to make sure. The only problem is with the prop, before you raise it up out of the water, you just need to make sure the prop's up and down doing it this way. So I figure I can manage that, and I wanted to mount it as close to the boat as possible, because the closer to the kayak the closer to the kayak as possible, gives you more control and stability and with and performance out of your motor. Another thing I thought I could do was just leave this. See, I got a this right here, just how far you want your trolling motor to go up or down. It's like a collar. I could leave this loose. The only thing is that controls how loose the steering is, but I could leave it loose. And instead of turning the knob, I could just basically lift it up and then lock it in when I come into shore. But that's how I'm gonna work it. So I think it's gonna be all right. Now, of course, in my state, which is Virginia, if you put a motor on anything, an inner tube, a kayak, canoe, a rubber raft, you have to register the canoe and you have to put your registration numbers on the canoe or kayak or whatever. And guys, I went to a boating supply store and bought lettering to stick on my kayak. But the only problem is, kayaks, the letters won't stick on there. So what I did, I bought some stencils. They're made out of like thin plastic. They're about the thickness of a sheet of paper, but they're really strong. And I taped that whole thing together with the spaces in between with that painter's tape. So I had a stencil that long. And then I taped the whole thing to the boat or to the kayak. And then I bought a dollar birthday party, one of them paper tablecloth things for kids' birthdays. I bought that for a dollar and I used that to tape off my canoe, keep from getting any back spray on my canoe anywhere. Or canoe, kayak. So, and the trick, guys, to doing the stencils to keep from getting paint bleed under your stencils. I use spray paint, by the way. I use Krylon Fusion spray paint because it sticks to any surface. And they're on there pretty good. They're smooth. But the thing is, you need to get that Elmer's adhesive glue, and it's called permanent or temporary bond. And it takes forever to set. It takes like 4 or 5 days for it to bond permanently. It's like tacky. You spray it on the back of the stencils and you stick it on your boat, and that paint keeps the glue keeps the paint from going up under your stencils. And then I sprayed it. I put like a light coat like 3 times is what I did. And then I let it dry about 30 seconds or maybe a minute between coats, but about 30 seconds after I got all 3 coats on there. And then I just started peeling my stencils off. And then it takes about a day for the paint to really cure and dry onto the kayak where it's smooth and not sticky. And then after it dried for a couple of days, I took some warm water on a rag and I can get the glue residue off the letters because it was still tacky after 2 days and it comes right off of warm water. So anyway, that's my tip on painting your numbers on your kayak or canoe or whatever. Anyway, I guess that's all, guys. Alright, Hot Lead Retired out of here. Thanks for watching. If you got any questions about this, put them in the comments and I'll answer them. Thanks for watching.